Well, obviously the number one issue on everybody's agenda is the economy. Of course, we're in a recession now, and people are wondering when do we hit the bottom and what its impact is going to be on their ability to stay in their home and stay employed, or if you're unemployed, to get a job. Texas has been protected a little bit by the economic downturn, although we're not an island, and we're beginning to feel the effects of the credit crisis, where even small and established businesses are finding it hard to borrow money because banks and financial institutions are in bad shape. That was the theory behind the economic rescue package, although I have to say that I've not been pleased with the lack of transparency and accountability for how the money is spent, recognizing the fact that we have a $1.2 trillion deficit and that will likely grow with the passage of the stimulus package in a few weeks. So these are times when the federal government needs to get its house in order, just as average Texans do when they live within their means and don't overspend and maybe cut back a little bit when times are tough. But here in Washington, it seems like the powers that be keep printing money and hoping that that will work. I think we need more accountability and transparency, and we need to keep an eye on those growing deficits, which are going to be handed down to our children and grandchildren for them to pay, unless we get a comprehensive financial stabilization package passed, which would include not only the current economic crisis, it would also include eliminating deficit spending, that deficit, the IOUs we pass on down to our children and grandchildren, as well as dealing with the entitlement spending crisis, things like Social Security and Medicare, which are looming out there ready to swamp us.